Hello children, I hope that you all are well. Myself, Mrs. Tasneem, your grammar teacher from Mother of Hope School, Ashadam. Today, we will start with the first lesson of grammar, that is lesson number one, sentences. Today, I will teach you about sentences, statements, questions, WH questions. So let's begin with sentences. Here there are few groups of words. Let's read it. Dancing is a girl. Like cartoons I. Kitchen in is my mother the. Does this groups of words sounds correct? Does this groups of words make any sense? No, it does not. Now, let's read these groups of words. A girl is dancing. I like cartoons. My mother is in the kitchen. Now see, these groups of words make some sense. I have just arranged these words in proper sequence to make a sentence. So, a group of words which makes complete sense when put together is called a sentence. While writing a sentence, we should always keep these important points in mind. A sentence always begins with a capital letter. It often ends with a full stop or a question mark. Now, to understand the sentences more clearly, let's arrange these groups of words to make proper sentences. My best friend Rohit is. My best friend is Rohit. So, can you see the change? When I have simply arranged the group of words, it becomes a meaningful sentence. In this, I study school. I study in this school. Is what your name? What is your name? So, by just arranging the groups of words in proper sequence, we can form a sentence. And you can see all these sentences begin with capital letter and have punctuation mark. A sentence can be a statement as well as question. So now let's start with a statement. Statement, a sentence that tells something or express something is called as a statement. It starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. For example, today we are going to visit a zoo. Can you see here the sentence tells us something? So it's a statement. Second example, I am happy today. Here it expresses something, so it is a sentence. I hope it is clear to you now what is a statement. So we'll move further with questions. A sentence that asks someone something is called as a question. It also starts with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. For example, do you have a dog? So, see children, here I am asking something to someone that do you have a dog? So, it's a question. How are you? Again, here I am asking something to a particular person. So, it's a question. Now, let's see some more examples of statements and question. Here there are two columns. One is of statement, other is of question. Let's read it out. Rama is clever. It's a statement. So when we change this statement into a question, it becomes, is Rama clever? Second one, they are cousins. So when we make it a question, it becomes, are they cousins? Like that, here statements are given and questions are given. So you have to read it and you can see what are the statements and what are the questions. I hope now you are clear with the statements and questions. Now let's learn how to form WH questions. Usually question starts with one of the following words, that is when, where, who, why, what, which, how. Let's learn how to use this WH questions and where to use it. Okay, we'll start with the first one, that is when. When always talks about the time. So we always ask question when we want to know a time of a particular event. For example, we can say, when is your birthday? Number two is where. Where talks about the place. Whenever we want to know place, we use where. For example, we can say, where are you going? Next one is who. Who talks about the person. This is always used to know about the person or people. For example, we can say, who are you? The next WH question is why. It is used to give some reason. Many times we have to give reasons for something, and for that we use the question why. For example, why are you late today? What? It always denotes or gives us information about the object, an idea or an action. For example, what is she eating? What is your plan? What is this? Our next question word is which. It tells us about the things in particular. For example, which is your favorite food? Our last WH question is how. It tells us about the manner or the method of doing something. For example, how do you go to school? Even you can say, how are you? So this all are WH questions. Now I hope the concept of WH question is also clear. Thank you.